Okay, so this is the mid-week progress of week two in systems integration of our game Life on the Line. I'm not talking that loud because everyone is sleeping in my house because it's almost midnight. Okay, I'll show you what we've done so far. So what we've done, I'm pretty familiar with this, the controls menu. My mouse is not going to line up to the text, so just bear with it. So now we have the game progression stats, which gives you the grade, the score. This one says level under construction because it's still under construction, and that's why the letter's still N, but I'll show you how this works. I'll just beat the few levels. Oh, yeah, we made a pause menu. So, how this pause menu works is basically, we got this options thing here. You can click options. We can hire the music if we wish. Or we can just. Oh, or we can just like lower it to that low. Or we could brighten up the level if we wish. I think that's good right there. Mouse sensitivity, I can show you that right now. So this is me moving the mouse around. Now if I go to options, go to mouse sensitivity, put it all the way up, which is ridiculous. It moves really fast and it's really sensitive, which some people like sensitive, but I don't. So that's going back down to here. So you can either push resume, which would take you out of the pause menu, or hit escape again to go back into the game. With this box, we were having some issues with it bouncing when the player picked it up and walked around. That's no longer an issue, so let's put this over here. We fixed the jump so the player jumps better. Added the fading blood effect instead of having the blood constantly stay there for the player. Let's grab that. We textured the power lines. I'll show you that in a second. Let me grab that. Okay, go. I should have picked a more sensitive mouse. Break the glass. Okay, so we see the power lines. We cut the power. And they turn black, so now we know that they're off. And another thing that we did was click that, and then shows you the note. Let's put in this code. Got the money. Pick the lock. Unscrew these. We also implemented a secondary crouch button, which is the scrolling bar on the mouse. I got a B? Wow. That's really weird. Okay, I guess that's fair, I guess. Whatever. So let's go to level 2. I'm not going to beat level 3 because it takes way too long and I'm tired. Come on. There we go. Pick the lock. Go get the wire cutters over here. They're still on the floor. You can see the wires powering the power grid. Does this hurt me? I think it does. Ooh, yeah, it does. Ooh. Okay. So yeah, let's not do that. Cut the power off, the lines shut off. Pick up the card. Let's go. Inventory. I only have a lockpick and wire cutters. I don't know why it thinks I have my shoes on. I gotta be because I got hurt. Whatever. I don't care. Load up this level. Let's quit to the main menu. Go to progress. So that's what I got in the store level. And that's what I got in cell block A. Now, if I restart the game, these would still be up here. And then when it's not really considered saving a high score, it just shows you what your last progress was in that level. But we have this little reset button here, and if we push it, it resets everything. But if I still click continue, I will still end up being in the central hub area. No, I'm not. That's weird. Why am I not in the central hub? Let's see what went wrong. Mistakes were made. Probably just a value thing. There's probably two in there at the end of the level where there should actually be a three. Oh, do you know what? I think it's the autosave feature inside level three. That needs to be fixed. Yeah, I think that's what it is. It's the autosave feature. No, I'm still in cell block A. Very strange. Well, I'll go fix that before I go to bed. Well, that wasn't the whole purpose of this. The whole purpose of this video was basically this right here. I'll show you. Game progress stats feature in our game. Well, I gotta go fix those issues, and I will post another video on Sunday.